Today I am going to discuss about engineering materials. In present society, each and every compound is manufactured with different materials. There are so many engineering materials, both are conventional and advanced materials. The engineering materials are classified as two types. First one, metals, non-metals, and the metals is classified into two types. What are those? Ferrous metals and non-ferrous metals. Ferrous metals and non-ferrous metals. Coming to ferrous metals, the metals which are attracted by magnet. The metals which are attracted by magnet. We can define in another way. The metals which contain ferrous content. The metals which contain ferrous content. These materials are known as ferrous materials. Once again I am explaining. Ferrous materials are those materials which are attracted by magnet. Okay. Examples: steel and cast iron, steel and cast iron. Coming to non-ferrous metals, the metals which are not attracted by magnet are the metals which don't have any ferrous metal. Okay, these metals are known as non-ferrous metals. Examples: aluminium, manganese, zinc, copper, sulfur, etc. Aluminium, copper, zinc, etc. These are the metals. Coming to non-metals. Okay. These are classified into clay products, ceramics, glasses, components. These are the non-metals. Okay, first one, coming to ceramics. These are the materials which are formed by the combination of any two or three materials. These are the materials which are formed by the combination of any two or three materials. Both are non-metals. Coming to clay products. The products which are manufactured with the clay. Okay. The metals which are manufactured with clay. And glasses. And final components. These are the materials classified in different ways. This is the engineering materials. Okay. Coming to engineering material properties. Okay, there are so many properties based on their structure, based on their process, based on their manufacture. Those are stress, strain, ductility, malleability, elasticity, plasticity, toughness, creep, fatigue. These are the different mechanical properties. Okay. Coming to stress. What is stress? Stress is defined as the formula. When a particular load acts on a particular area of the material or surface, then the particular load means P. is acted on the particular area of the workplace, then it is known as stress. Okay. It is defined as, it is classified into two types. Temporary stress, compressive stress. Temporary stress and compressive stress. Coming to tensile stress. Suppose we take a particular object after length L and width B. Will be deformed. That means there is a change in its length. When we apply the load, the length of the object should be increases. Then it is known as tensile stress. Load is applied on a particular object, it will be expanded. So, it is the original length, it is the deformation length. Okay. This load is known as tensile load. This stress is known as tensile stress. When we apply the load on the object, the length should be decreases. Suppose this is the object, when the load should be applied in opposite direction, inside to the object, then the length should be decreases. This is the original length. Now, this is the deformation length. So there is a change in the length. So when the length is decreases, then it is known as compressive strain. Okay. Next one, strain. It is the ratio of change in length to original length. If suppose it is the original length, but when we apply some load, what happens? There is some increase in the length. What is the change in length? Suppose if it is 20 mm. It is 20 mm. After we apply some load of 15 N. Okay, so it will expand to 25 mm. What is the change in length? 5 mm. So change in length 5 mm by original length 20 mm. Okay, so what is the strain? Next, coming to Young's modulus. It capital E is denoted by capital E. It is the ratio of stress to strain. Is the ratio of stress to strain.